Hey everybody, Paradise has been out a week. Been wanting to make a video like this for a long time where I talk about the making of the song and hopefully do it in a way that's interesting to people that aren't musicians, because obviously I don't want to bore everyone, but I do think that this stuff can be fascinating if done the right way. So I'm gonna dive in, talk about this song. Started it in 2019 in LA. Went to a studio called Gold Diggers, which is an amazing studio. Can't recommend it highly enough. And I didn't really have an agenda. I just knew that I wanted a space in LA where I could like bring people through to work and to kind of connect, and we could just make music with very little agenda. So I reached out to my manager and some friends, and we were talking about different people who could come out and maybe from London to kind of just hang with me, to just kick it and make music. And I had done a session about a year and a half beforehand with a producer called Lil Silva, a guy called TJ. He is an amazing musician. And it was a bit of it was strange on paper because like we'd never done anything for me before, but we kind of just, it felt like we connected and it felt like we would get on. So I asked him if he would fly out to LA, and he did. He rolled up in the studio and we started working, and it was just immediately, you could just tell we were going to make something really great. The song Paradise was probably the first thing we started, and we went on a 4 or 5 day run where every day we ended up starting something that ended up on the album. So it was really special. How this song started was based on this loop I'll play for you now. It was a drum loop, just a drum loop that he started playing. I jumped on a synthesizer called an OB6, which is a Dave Smith emulation of an Oberheim synthesizer. So that was the loop that we started. That's the loop we built. And TJ was on Logic. He's really amazing at just adding stuff in real time. He would just add a lot of little flavors, little sounds, little subtleties. And I was just playing the synth over and over and over again. When normally I do that in the studio, I know it's going to be something. I can just tell there's a difference between playing C major and playing C major over a drum beat, which gives you something and all of a sudden elevates C major into a different world. Do you know what I mean? Like there's something special that happens and elevates, in this case, a D major chord. And a very, like the changes wouldn't have happened if his drum beat hadn't locked in the way it did and he hadn't added these little things. It all felt very meant to be. I rarely play and write songs on guitar. It's more often I bounce off ideas like this in the studio. I'm quite a physical writer. So I'll pick up a handheld microphone, SM57, SM7, whatever it is, just sing whatever comes in my head. Again, anyone that does this professionally will know you have to have an amount of like lack of regard for whether things are good or bad. And you just have to sing them like with spirit into the room and just trust that eventually something will land. So this is the melody, and this is literally the first time I ever sang this song is this section here. Decided that we're going to keep the main chord progression the whole way through the song. It just didn't feel like it needed to change. So we kind of locked in pretty quickly. He added some little bits. We flipped a bit in. There's no bass on the verses of this song. If you listen to it again, that was a conscious thought on my part. I like the dynamic weight that a bass guitar can bring, or a synth bass. In this case, it was a Moog, can bring. Sometimes if you put your bass in on your verse, you've got nowhere to go with your low end. I learned that when I was making Rising Water with 1985. He's a master of like subtractive production. You put in the bare minimum of what you need to do. And if you listen to that song again, it's very similar to this. The verses have very little going on. The choruses have very little going on, but it's about how you deploy your arsenal of tricks. So yeah, that's day one. You hear that little synthesizer, the organ thing that comes in. That was TJ jumping on an Omnisphere thing. just like bam, 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 that thing. I love that so much because it's, again, subtlety. It was these little ideas that lifted the sections. And what's funny about this is actually the vocal that I used in the sampler is the top line vocal from the song Headlights, which is also on the album. And you can hear it at the end. If you go to the end of the section, you can hear here. So that's me saying headlights over and over again, but super pitched up, obviously. But if you hear this, this comes in on this just before the second chorus. And it's just gave it so much life in the studio as soon as we did it. Like, I remember both of us just kind of like losing our shit. Like, holy, that like just sounds so hype. So that's me just kind of pressing different keys on my keyboard and hoping I'm in the right key at all times. And that the next note that I come in and bring in on the right hand added more drama and weight. And when you listen to that in context, when you go listen to the song, if you listen to the second chorus, you hear it come in. And if you follow it through in the background, you'll see it adds a little bit of drama and weight to what is an otherwise pretty barren production at that point. So that's where we had it coming out of LA. When we got back home, we went back to London. We went into a studio called the Church Studio. And we were downstairs working on this song. And we were trying a lot of stuff, adding a lot of stuff to it. We felt like we had it in a good place. I would say at one point we actually felt like we had it done. But as we kind of progressed, it just didn't feel like we had it all there. I tend to write my lyrics by myself. Like, it's not from like a dictatorial thing. I really love collaboration. But lyrics in this album were I'd say 99% written by me because I'm the one that has to sing it. So if I have to sing it, I need to be able to stand behind it. So my experience is my experience. So I tend to go and write the song a bit in solitude. I'll take what we have, the backing track, and go right to it. So at this point, I'd written the song and I had the idea of the lyric on the chorus, which is the pretend that we're surrounded, pretend I got what it takes to drive us out of town, love, avoiding where the other bodies lay. Kind of knew when I had that I had something that felt quite special. We had a really good production and it sounded like this. So if you get to the chorus part there, you see it's actually got a bit of like a reggae swing to it, which is not something that I hadn't thought about with this song, but just that boom, ba 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 ba. I think that kind of upstrum thing made me think a little bit more about what we needed in there rhythmic wise to play off the staticness of the drums and the staticness of the chords. So I went back to my studio in Dublin and I brought in a bunch of like piccolo snares and marching snares and I made this. And that was a huge breakthrough. And then the next huge breakthrough was the introduction of Paul Epworth into the song. I flew over from Dublin to meet him with the intention, and I flew back the same day. My whole agenda was to just meet him, make sure that we got on a personal level. He has a good relationship with TJ, so I knew that I could bring these songs in and we could all collaborate in a really like holistic, proper way. I just let him do his thing. He started feeling the song out, and in the same way with Gone, the first thing he did was he put in the marching band and the Cuban rhythm section and shit and really turned that into something special. You might not even notice it in the song, but it's the whole way through the song, and he did this in real time. So if you listen to the song, you go back and listen to it, you'll hear that pretty much the whole way through it. And it gives this constant pulse, which on a slow song, the song is only like 88 BPM, which is slow. It gives it forward motion. So when you hear it on the radio, it feels languid, but it pushes forward. They're the little things that I would never get to in a million years. So Paul Epworth was key. I could play hundreds of different stems from that, but I've been talking a while. I don't want to like get bogged down in it, but... And then I came back to Dublin and I woke up one morning and I was like, this has never happened to me before. And I was like, I need to put a kids choir on this song. And I love the spirit and energy that you can't get it. Like, gospel choirs are amazing and choirs in general are amazing, but kids singing in unison voice, because they're just they're all different. Every kid is so unique and they're not trying to lock into each other. They're just singing and it's amazing. You can't replicate it. I can't do it in the studio. I can't fake my voice. I can't use a plugin to get it. So I woke up and was like, we need a gospel choir. I texted Paul and Paul was just, I assume people would be like, you're crazy. What the fuck? The song is done. Leave it alone. But he just came back and said, yeah, absolutely. I know a person to call. And then a week later, I flew over to London. They came to the studio and they just absolutely, they changed the whole song again. They just flipped it into something so magical. So this is what they sounded like.
Pretend I was surrounded by this paradise. Oh, 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 by this paradise. Oh, 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 by.
That was the last thing that we added to the song. It went to Manny Marroquin to mix, and his one of his assistants, Chris Galland. Just brilliant humans. They literally sent back a version and it was done. I didn't need any fixes, changes. They just work on a level that's so perfect. And then it went to Chris Athens to master. Again, also a mastering genius. Sent back a version, done. And it was, that was it. That's how the song was made. I'll play the final version now. Sure, you can listen to more of that by yourself. I just wanted to play it all a little bit in isolation. Yeah, but thank you so much. Thank you for listening to all the songs so far, listening to Paradise. I'm excited to play for everyone live. I'm excited to just do more stuff, not just be on a camera all the time. So I'll talk to you guys soon. Okay, yeah, bye-bye.